from its chilling origins and its unexpected twist in the American military's hands.
I hope to God it'll torture you to madness.
Metallica's Enter Sandman is a story worth exploring. Discover the song's darker beginnings and transformation into a metal masterpiece with Lars Ulrich's unique contribution to the intro. Dive into the intriguing world of Enter Sandman, Metallica's most commercial success. Hey, what's up guys, I'm Brian, welcome back to my channel. Here I like to dive into the history behind metal songs and the bands that created them. As you can tell, I love dissecting Metallica's music, from their iconic guitar tones to my personal take on their songs. And from this sprang the idea to cover all the songs from their first five albums. Thank you for joining me on this journey, and let's get into Enter Sandman. Enter Sandman is one of their most iconic songs. It was released as a single on July 29th, 1991, as a lead-up to launching their iconic Black Album, which released on August 12th, 1991. The recording of Enter Sandman and the entire Black Album took place from October 6th, 1990 to June 16th, 1991. This song and album signified a significant shift in Metallica's songwriting. As everyone knows, they shifted to a more crowd-friendly sound and song structure.
The song's so catchy, most people probably don't listen to the lyrics.
This change came from a realization that they had during the Injustice for Album touring cycle. They quickly realized that these songs were overly complicated and very long, and they could see in the crowd that the fans were getting bored of their 9 to 10 minute songs.
And it was so boring.
This prompted them to aim for shorter and better well-written songs. They enlisted the help of Bob Rock for this album, which would mark the first of four albums they would work on together. Funnily enough, Enter Sandman was actually the first song that they composed for the album. The song's core riff was conceived by Kirk Hammett, and was further refined by Lars Ulrich. The main riff for the song actually drew inspiration from Louder Than Love that Kirk had been listening to. The lyrics underwent revisions as well, because it had started out as a much darker theme and became what we know as a song today. Enter Sandman would mark the band's second music video, and it was directed by Wayne Isham. The music video's theme aligns with the lyrics of the song. As a single, Enter Sandman saw 7 different releases. As a part of these releases, it achieved platinum and gold statuses. And even more remarkably, it still holds a place on the iTunes chart even to this day. The live debut of Enter Sandman occurred on August 1st, 1991, a mere 11 days before the release of the album, at the Phoenix Theater in Petaluma, California. It has since been performed live a staggering 1,398 times, making it the most frequently played track from the Black Album and the 6th most performed song in Metallica's entire catalog. Being among the best of Metallica's songs, it appears on a lot of live CDs and DVDs, including Live Ship Engine Purge, Cunning Stunts, S&M 1 and 2, among so many others. Enter Sandman has appeared in video games like Rockman and Guitar Hero Metallica. It has served as wake-up music for NASA astronauts, walkout music for Mariano Rivera, the pitcher for the Yankees, and became an unofficial theme for Virginia Tech sports. Even more bizarrely, the song was used as an instrument of torture during the Iraq War. The song was used because they wanted to play music that was culturally offensive to the people they were torturing, an action that the band and Lars Ulrich did not condone whatsoever. Enter Sandman by Metallica lasts 5 minutes and 31 seconds and is credited to Metallica's core trio of Hammett, Lars Ulrich, and James Hetfield. Interestingly, the name Enter Sandman had actually been in song titles for years before the album's actual release. The song structure follows a typical pop format of intro, verse, chorus, bridge, chorus, outro. Notably, the bridge features a unique call and response between James Hetfield and Bob Rock's son presenting a bedtime prayer. As I mentioned before, the song actually had a lot darker lyrics that James had been working on for a while. Originally, the song was about sudden infant death syndrome.
You are kind of edgy, aren't you?
And everyone in the band deemed this too dark for the song, especially because they felt like this might be one of the premier singles for the album. So this led to Lars and Bob asking James to revise the song, and now we get the song that we have today, the one that's about childhood nightmares. The chorus was also influenced by Bob Rock, who wanted James to use less words and just sing using syllables to fit the cadence of the chorus. Enter Sandman showcases Metallica's prowess at songwriting and writing catchy songs, while maintaining a straightforward instrumental approach. And it's a testament to their commercial commercial success. For this song, James Hetfield used his famous ESP MX-220 with the EMG 8160 combo that he's famous for using, and his Mesa Boogie Mark II C+, standard fare for the albums that they've been recording so far. And that all went into Marshall cabs with vintage 30s in them. Here's my tone for the song. So here's my clean tone. So once again, I'm using my Harley Benton EX84 with the 8160 combo that James uses. I'm using my Ajax Stomp, and it's going into a Tube Screamer clone, which I know James didn't really like using Tube Screamers after Ride the Lightning, but I like it to tighten up the tone. Then it's going into a Mesa Boogie Mark IV clone, and that's going into a Black Album IR that I can all link in the description, as well as this tone. And then my clean tone's going into a Roland Jazz Chorus clone and a Roland Jazz Chorus IR that I can link in the description as well. Okay, so let's dive into some guitar parts. You have the main riff of the song, though. And originally, Kirk was playing it like this. And then that's where Lars came in and changed it to the part we know now, the three. And this is the tail end. There's one main riff, and what Bob Rock helped them do was turn that riff into the other parts of the song. They all use the same notes, but in different arrangements. My favorite part is the build-up after the clean guitar intro. And I recently found out it's not the open E, but it's the F chord they do in the intro. And then for the rest of it, they're doing the... It comes back to that E and not the F like they do for the intro and the outro. Ben Eller actually made a great video on this part of the song that you can see right here. It's a really cool video just breaking down how the intro is an overture for the song, and it presents all what you're gonna hear in the song. And I really like how they just reverse it for the outro. And I think it's really cool. And this video is really cool if you wanna check it out as well. So what I forgot to mention during the video is the intro. The intro is a little weird. I used to play it like, which a lot of beginners do, because this song has a really weird fingering position, and the tabs don't really teach you that. It's really, you're supposed to hold out these two notes. Because if you hear the isolated guitar track, that's what James is actually doing. He's holding out those two notes. So before we get into the song, I just want to give some final thoughts on this song. Enter Sandman really occupies a special place in their discography. It's a song that's left an indelible mark on the rock and metal landscape. From its release as a single for the legendary Black Album, to its enduring presence for its fans across the world, Enter Sandman is a testament to Metallica's evolution as a band and songwriters. The song's journey, from the band's need to make a change songwriting-wise after the complexity of the And Justice for All album and touring cycle, to the guidance by Bob Rock, demonstrates the band's commitment to their craft. It's a journey that gave birth to an entirely new sound for Metallica, one that was widely accessible and widely profitable, propelling them to new commercial heights. Enter Sandman really was more than just a song. It was a cultural phenomenon. It helped keep the band afloat during the early days of the grunge days, where the metal scene was suffering from new music taking over. Its music video, its numerous live performances, and its presence in video games and sporting events have solidified its place in popular culture. On a more personal note, Enter Sandman holds a unique place in my journey as a guitarist. It's one of the first songs that I ever learned, and I played it for a very long time in my teenage thrash band when we needed songs to play. While I don't listen to it much anymore, I still use it as a good warm-up song. Overall, I can't deny its widespread success, and it does hold a special place in my heart because it was a song that I relied on for so many years. It's one of those songs I would have a hard time forgetting. As I've delved into the intricacies of Enter Sandman, I've really grown to appreciate it more. The iconic riff, the catchy chorus, and the masterful songwriting all contribute to its enduring appeal. It's a song, even though I'm familiar with it, it still continues to teach me unique perspectives in songwriting. If you enjoyed what you watched, I've made a few Metallica videos already, and I plan to do more. Don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe. I plan on doing more of these, like I said. I want to cover all the songs from Metallica's first 5 albums. And if you can think of anything that I missed, please leave in the comments. Let me know. Let me know your favorite live performance. Let me know where you first heard this song. And if you have any suggestions for me on what songs I could do next, what songs you want to hear, please leave them in the comments below as well. Peace.